Hi, and welcome to this video where I'm going to talk about how you set up an analytics team, especially for people who aren't from a data background. So a lot of the time, if you're asked to set up an analytics team, you might not have a background in data analytics or data science. So how do you go about doing that? Now, one of the things that I've done this quite a lot, but also I've advised people who've set up analytics team, is that you're typically asked to set up an analytics team because there is a particular need. So the business either wants some reports or some questions answered, or they want the analytics on a new offering or a new product that they've launched that collects data now or has data, or they want to start the journey. So you might be part of the strategy team, part of a tech team, part of the product team, and you've been asked how to set up an analytics team. Now, depending on what budget's been signed off, you typically find that they sign off for one analyst first, okay? There have been occasions where I've sort of advised people where three or four analysts have been signed off from day one, but that's usually organizations that feel that they need to accelerate because they're far behind in the data journey. But typically you'll find that they'll sign off one analyst. Okay, so who do you hire? Okay, so if you want to know how to hire, please look at my video on how to interview for a data analyst. But if you're hiring someone, look for a doer. Okay, so what you want is someone who can come in from day one, get their hands dirty, and start answering business questions. Okay, so this person needs to have a broad set of skills, so they're able to import data, they're able to analyze, transform, manipulate data, and they're also able to go back to the stakeholders and present the findings. Okay, now they may not be good at all of that, but they should be able to do the whole thing, even if some of those areas are weaker, because you'd expect them to learn, and with your support, especially on the more business focused areas, you can help them. But on the technical stuff, obviously you won't be able to help them because you're not from a data background. But on the technical analytical point of view, whether to what models to run or how to import data into a particular tool or how to run a particular query, you can't help them. So make sure they're very good at that, and you need to tell them that at the interview. You need to say to them, look, I'm hiring someone who's self-sufficient, independent, can do everything themselves, and I'm there to support because you're not from a data background. Okay, so you get this doer in, and what you need to do is make sure that, I would say within weeks, show value. Okay, there's no point hiring this person, disappearing for six months, while you're investigating data sources and trying to solve things, and then presenting back 6 months, because the business would have moved on and they probably won't be interested anymore, and you've lost that opportunity to grow a data team. So in my experience, what I found is that typically the business makes a decision to hire a data analyst or start a data function within a company. It takes 3 months to get that signed off, 3 months for you to recruit. So it's already 6 months gone. So you need to be in weeks to be able to show results. And there's some easy stuff that you can do. So sometimes, like for example, the marketing team don't know how their campaigns perform, and that data sits in certain tools, and you find the analysts can come in, they can just export that data from the system, import it into their tool, analyze it, run whatever they need to run, and produce back results within 2-3 weeks. Okay, and that's brilliant because you've shown immediate value, and that is what the business is looking for. Okay, you don't hire analysts to do analysis, you hire analysts to show value to the business. Okay, and usually that business value in the early days is decision making. Okay, it helps them make better and more informed decisions. Okay, so now you've got this doer and they're plowing away and they're showing a lot of value. At some point you'll find that they're maxed out. Okay, but the business wants more. Okay, so what I typically do is I have done in the past is hire a junior. I have in the past once hired an equivalent for that person because I thought to myself, look, this person is doing really well. If I hire someone similar to them, then I can double the capacity. But that doesn't work, or that didn't work. And the reason that didn't work is because twofold. One is they end up competing and you find that they're doing things differently and the business is not getting the consistency. And the second thing is the first person who you've brought in, who's had all this free rein to go to different parts of the business and help different parts of the business answer problems, is now finding that they're being sidelined because someone else has been brought in. What I do is now, and I advise people to do, is hire juniors. Okay, so you've got the senior person who's come in and they're a doer and they're answering all these questions, they're talking to stakeholders. So that's something I should mention. Actually, the first person you bring in, the doer, should be at a senior level analyst who's got 4 or 5 years experience. Okay, and then I bring in a junior, even if it's a grad. Okay, I mean, ideally not a grad, someone with 1 year's experience would be good, but if you can't find it, or if your budget's not been signed off, then get a grad who's very good at the technical skills, because then what will happen is that the senior person will do hand over stuff to them, and one of the motivations for them to hand over stuff to the junior person is that they can go and branch off into other areas. Okay, so they will then go on a journey of handing over things to the junior person, and then the junior person will pick those up and then start delivering for the business, and they will start growing and they'll enjoy it. And you'll find that it'll occupy them for at least 2 years. They'll be really enjoying getting all this, learning this new stuff and delivering for the business. And then the senior person grows their role. And then what happens then is that senior person with support from yourself will go into other areas. So they may have come in to help marketing and product, and then they eventually go into strategy, or they go into sales, and they start helping other teams. And you find that then the need for data analysis grows within the business, because the business starts seeing the value, and then you can start planning properly. Because you've already got two people delivering, you can start saying, look, next wave, I'm going to put a business case together that I need another two more people so I can replicate that. And therefore, you might get another senior person to help, you know, the first person that you got who's senior, and another junior, or whatever combination you think works for you. Okay, and then eventually from that, you will then grow your team. And you know, it will sustain itself because it will keep showing value. Okay, and at some point you will then need to hire a manager or a lead, because you'll get to a point where those senior people need someone who can help with their career progression. And if you're not from a technical, but if you're not from an analytics or a data background, you won't be able to do that. So get a lead, and then it means you become more strategic in running that data team and growing it. And so that's really my advice for if you're from a non-data background and you've been asked to grow or build an analytics team. That's how I would go about doing that. Thank you very much for watching my video. Please do comment below, and if you have any questions, please do ask them also below. Please like the video and, of course, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.